Hello, this is Max. Scientists went to Mars, but accidentally there was an extra person on board, which put the entire expedition in jeopardy. You can subscribe to the channel after watching. It helps us a lot in realizing the content. In a space expedition funded by the Hyperion Corporation, three astronauts embark on a two-year journey to Mars. The crew comprises mission commander Marina, biologist David, and medical researcher Zoe. Although the launch is a bit rocky, Marina's exceptional piloting skills allow them to safely depart Earth. Marina initiates a careful spin to generate artificial gravity and deploys their solar panels, with the spinning motion causing some discomfort for David but providing a thrilling experience for Zoe. This mission holds special significance for Marina as it marks her last assignment before retirement. Upon successfully docking their spacecraft with the station, David takes a moment to recover from the journey while Zoe explores the surroundings, marveling at the breathtaking view of Earth through a window. They personalize their new bedrooms with memorabilia and add their signatures to a wall adorned with those of previous astronauts. They also prepare the equipment needed for their experiments. After settling in and enjoying a snack, they establish a connection with the base for an interview. Zoe reflects on her initially playful application to Hyperion, which turned into an incredible opportunity. David acknowledges the challenge of leaving his wife for 2 years but underscores the importance of his research in paving the way for human colonization of Mars. Later, as Marina checks the spacecraft systems, she notices blood on the floor and realizes it is dripping from a compartment above. Using a power tool, she opens the compartment, causing an unconscious man to fall out and inadvertently injuring her arm in the process. As air starts escaping from the damaged panel, David and Zoe rush to assist the stranger and take him to the infirmary, while Marina attempts unsuccessfully to repair the compartment. Following the sealing of the door to prevent further oxygen loss, Marina discovers the identity of the man as Michael, a member of the launch support team. She contacts Hyperion for assistance in determining how Michael ended up on board. At the infirmary, Zoe examines Michael's injuries, uncovering a significant bleeding wound that she promptly stitches up. Later, she 3D prints a cast to protect Marina's injured arm. With the ship's damage, carbon dioxide levels are higher than normal, prompting David to address the issue using their extra tanks. When Michael regains consciousness, he is startled to find himself in space and experiences a moment of panic. Zoe manages to calm him down with reassuring words, and the rest of the crew joins in to question him. Michael, a launch engineer, recalls arming the second stage firing pins but has no memory after that. Upon learning that they departed 12 hours ago, he becomes distressed, expressing the need to return to his sister, who is alone on Earth. Marina explains the limitations of their current situation but assures Michael they will contact Hyperion for a solution. The crew shares their food with Michael, and Marina informs him that Hyperion has checked on his sister, who is doing well and will have full-time care provided. Michael apologizes for his earlier panic and expresses a willingness to contribute to the crew's tasks. The crew warmly welcomes him, and Zoe gives him a tour of the ship, showcasing the stunning view of Earth. Despite there being only 3 beds, Michael sleeps on a stretcher, experiencing a restless night. The next day, he assists David with data entry, with David tending to his plants while they listen to jazz music. Michael teases David about his music choice, and David explains the unique appeal of jazz's unpredictability and expressive nature. Meanwhile, Zoe dons an astronaut suit and attempts to repair the damaged compartment with Marina's guidance. After completing the task, they notice that Michael's stitches have reopened, prompting Zoe to take him back to the infirmary. While caring for his wound, Michael expresses gratitude for Zoe's kindness and reveals a significant burn scar on his chest when asked to remove his shirt for better access. David provides an update to Marina, explaining that he has used up half of his algae reserves and achieved only half of the required oxygen output. Marina instructs him to use the remaining half as well, which greatly upsets David. Using all of it would leave him unable to conduct his research upon reaching Mars, effectively destroying years of work. David is reluctant to discard all his efforts when there might still be a chance to repair the compartment. However, Marina finally admits that the compartment is beyond repair, leaving David with no alternative but to use all his plants. He reluctantly destroys some well-growing algae and sets up additional bottles to expand algae cultivation. In the meantime, Michael sends a video message to his sister, expressing how he initially thought he would be a burden but has since found his place among the crew, forming genuine friendships and even being allowed to add his name to the wall with the other astronauts. Although his journey to space was accidental, it has turned into a significant opportunity. David checks on the second batch of algae and is devastated to find that it has failed. Marina struggles to hold back tears when reporting this setback to Hyperion and discussing their limited options. Subsequently, she breaks the news to Zoe, explaining that even with David's efforts on the algae, there is only enough oxygen on board for three people to survive. When Marina suggests the possibility of parting with Michael, a heated argument ensues. Zoe is appalled by the notion of sacrificing a human life before exhausting all other options. She points out the presence of a large tank of liquid oxygen used during the launch that might still contain some usable oxygen. However, Marina expresses concerns about the risk and feasibility of checking it via the tether. While Zoe insists on considering alternative solutions, Marina claims that Hyperion has already explored every possibility, but Zoe remains unwilling to accept this verdict. As they still have approximately 20 days before reaching a critical point, Zoe suggests waiting as long as possible to find a solution, despite David's objections. Marina ultimately disregards David's disagreement and grants Zoe a 10-day window. They also decide to withhold the grim news from Michael for the time being. Following their discussion, Marina communicates with Hyperion once again, defending her choice to delay and emphasizing the importance of exploring all avenues, even if they seem futile, to prevent overwhelming guilt among the crew. 3 days later, while Zoe checks on Michael's wound, he notices her observing his scar, prompting him to share the story behind it. At the age of 9, his apartment caught fire, leaving him and his sister orphaned. Since then, he has been the primary caretaker for his sister, and they rely on each other for support. Later, Zoe privately weeps in her room. Growing impatient with the waiting, David makes a difficult decision to break the rule. He approaches Michael and explains that they have exhausted all options, making it impossible to obtain more oxygen. He believes that if there were an alternative, Hyperion would have found it by now. David offers Michael a lethal injection, assuring him it will be painless and apologizing before departing. Michael becomes emotional as he looks at the bracelet his sister made for him and examines the deadly needle. However, Michael ultimately decides to do the right thing. He records another video message for his sister, apologizing for not being able to be with her every step of the way and acknowledging her strength. Despite the challenging circumstances, he speaks fondly of the crew. Shortly afterward, Zoe finds Michael sitting quietly with the needle nearby, unable to summon the courage to use it. She reassures him that he doesn't have to take that path. While Michael appreciates her determination to fight for him, he believes it's a hopeless situation. Zoe, however, disagrees and shares her own story. 12 years ago, she attempted to rescue a drowning man at the beach. She spent 5 minutes struggling to keep his head above water, nearly drowning herself, until they were unexpectedly saved by a passerby in a boat. At the time, she had no knowledge that help was coming, but she clung to hope. Zoe assures everyone that she won't give up and then confers with David, who believes that Michael effectively died when they launched the spacecraft. His frustration grows as he continues to lose algae, essentially erasing all his life's work. However, Zoe remains determined and refuses to accept this grim outcome. As a last resort effort to reach the tank, she begins teaching Michael how to climb the tether. Unfortunately, Michael struggles with the task, repeatedly slipping and falling, which results in him hitting his forehead. Faced with desperation, Zoe approaches Marina and David, requesting permission to climb the tether herself and asking David to accompany her since Michael is unable to do it. Surprisingly, David agrees, and he shares his reasoning. The first batch of algae has also perished, leaving only enough oxygen for two individuals. The launch tank represents their sole lifeline. Minutes later, David and Zoe suit up and embark on the challenging 450-meter climb. Initially, it proves to be quite difficult, requiring considerable effort. However, as they ascend and move farther from the artificial gravity, the climb becomes easier, especially during breaks. They reach the solar array halfway up, where they must exercise extreme caution, as a misstep could permanently disrupt the spacecraft's power supply. The duo advances slowly and cautiously, utilizing a rope to maintain their balance and successfully traverse the array without causing damage. After a bit more climbing, they reach the opposite end of the ship, with Zoe taking the lead to approach the containment containing the tank. With careful movements, Zoe opens the containment door, revealing the tank. After confirming that the gauge reads over 500, indicating an ample oxygen supply, she reports the news to Marina. David lowers a cylinder with a rope, which Zoe retrieves and connects to the pipe to begin filling it. Although the seal is imperfect, causing some oxygen to leak, it still provides enough for their needs. Once the canister is full, she sends it back up, and David prepares to lower the second one. However, their efforts are interrupted by an alarm signaling an approaching solar storm, adding a new layer of urgency to their already precarious situation. Marina issues a critical order for them to abort the mission, emphasizing that if they don't return within 20 minutes, the radiation from the impending solar storm will prove fatal. Zoe hastily exits the tank, leaving the second canister behind, thus ensuring that only three people will survive. She begins the hurried climb back, but while traversing the solar array to reach David, she loses control and hurtles rapidly toward the ship. She collides with it, accidentally releasing the canister, which vanishes into the vastness of space. The two of them return inside, and an awkward silence hangs in the air. David breaks the silence by noting that their only remaining hope lies in the second canister still inside the tank. Perhaps after the storm subsides, they can retrieve it, but Marina points out that the storm will last 4 hours, rendering them all dead by then. Michael offers to climb through the radiation and sacrifice himself to retrieve the canister since he feels responsible for the situation. However, they recognize that he is untrained and would never make it. Marina cannot go because she needs to pilot the ship. David attempts to volunteer next, but Zoe beats him to it. Zoe bids farewell to each member of the crew and embarks on the climb. The task becomes even more grueling, with the solar storm gradually scorching her face. Despite the immense effort and pain, she successfully reaches the tank and retrieves the canister. Without delay, she places it inside for the crew to collect. In silence, Marina silently expresses her gratitude for Zoe's self-sacrifice. Now, Zoe perches on top of the ship, her skin burning, and her breaths growing labored as she gazes at the stars and Mars in the distance, awaiting the inevitable effects of radiation poisoning. If you are interested in such films, please proceed to the next video on the screen, and also share your thoughts about this film in the comments. Give us a like and subscribe. Goodbye.